For the first time in its history, Red Cross Lifeblood is offering gifts in a bid to attract more donations. Regular donors can now score towels, socks, mugs and even T-shirts for rolling up their sleeves. But critics argue it's time to put cash on the table instead.
Donors like Jackie Hayes are the beating heart of this vital service.
I think I'm up to about my 30th donation. Makes you feel like you're really making a difference.
The milkshakes and snacks are a nice thank you too, but still only around 3 or 4% of Australians donate blood. And right now there's a shortage, particularly of plasma.
What we're seeing post-pandemic is that we still have the donors, but they don't come in as often.
So starting this week, they're trialling a new lure. Gifts, gym towels, lanyards, mugs, socks, bags and T-shirts. The more you donate, the more presents you get.
We've already had a few people ask to buy some merch as well, but just so you know, you can't buy it, you need to come in and donate.
I think in the end this is not going to solve the problem.
Professor Bob Slonim wants Aussie donors paid cash instead.
In Australian dollars, between $50 and $60 is what a donor is getting overseas. Here, they're just being told, thank you, you're a great person.
In the US, paid donors generate so much plasma, Australia buys it in because our donors generate less than half of what we need.
It's unfair because our donors are not being treated the same way as international donors are being treated.
But Lifeblood argues Aussie donors are different. We're not driven by the dollar, more a sense of altruism, that warm, fuzzy feeling you get when you know what you're doing is helping someone else.
I don't think it's the right thing to do. I mean, I think in the past Australia's had a pretty good volunteer culture and I just think that should continue.
But we don't believe it's a good use of taxpayer money, but we also don't think it engenders the right behaviours, and so I think those donors potentially could be less reliable in different volatile times.
Throwing in the towel, they hope, will get Australia's blood pumping once again. Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.